Football Media Day here for the Southland Conference. ACU back, a member of this conference that had helped co-found back 50 years ago, here with head football coach Ken Collins. And Ken, this is kind of the warm-up act because you're getting ready to go be interviewed by ESPN3 here in just a moment. So thanks for remembering the little people on your way to the top. We really appreciate it.
I guess that you're expecting me to tell you, you are the big time. Which, that's a warm-up for this.
No. Thanks for not big-timing me. Yeah. All right, so this is, you've been through media days before, but this is when it begins, is it not, to start feeling like, yeah, we're part of this thing, as opposed to press releases and logos and things. Now, all of a sudden, you're at media day with the other teams here.
Sure. I mean, the media day is still, you know, cameras in your face and lights and microphones and all that. But when you look around the room and see who's in there, there's some really good coaches. And it just reminds you that this thing is about a program, and you better have the pieces in place and a plan together and a staff that is pulling together to be able to do this thing. Because it's going to be a tight league.
Well, this year you only get Houston Baptist and Incarnate Word twice, members of the Southland Conference. It'll be 2014 that you start playing that full Southland Conference schedule. But as you say, you look around the room and, my gosh, Sam Houston State, 2 years in a row as an NCAA finalist, made it to the championship game twice, and then you've got your alma mater, That's University right. of Central Arkansas. They won the league last year.
That's right. You know, the worst thing you can do as a coach is to leave a game and feel like you got out-coached. And as you look around, it's like there's some pretty good coaches in there. And they put together some pretty good staffs, too. But guess what? We know what we're doing.
Yeah.
And we've got a good staff, and we've got a culture in place that's going to carry us through this thing.
You do have a new staff. And let's talk a little bit about some of the new faces, because you have some new coaches on your staff this year.
That's right. My newest guy is Andre Rowe. He is... he's going to coach my defensive line. Came from Navarro Junior College. Really good D-line coach. He is a guy who specializes in D-line play. He's going to go to bed thinking about D-line play. He's going to wake up in the morning thinking about D-line play, not about blitzes and cover three and all that. He's going to be thinking about those big guys. So that's exactly what I need.
Is he going to play with Nick Richardson some this season, do you think?
Yeah, I think he'll try to
work him into the rotation.
Maybe at end.
You know, defensive
where we might get a little pressure.
Get him on the defensive line. That's good. Coach, just as you start to move away now from some of the pageantry here, the media days, and into, forget media days, two-a-days coming up pretty soon, just give us an idea of the schedule here moving forward for you and your staff and your team.
Well, our schedule will be very similar to what it has been. We do, once fall camp hits around, you just try to be as efficient as you can. You don't want to overdo anything. You want to give guys plenty of rest. You're required to give them a certain amount of rest. I mean, it's pretty regimented, the NCAA, the rules that they put forth now. But all that fits into who we are and what we do. You still got to remember there's a balance. You got to balance between meetings and meals and staff meetings and not practicing too long. I mean, there's a lot that goes into it that we planned out, and we'll be able to execute that. And I'm excited about it. This will be very interesting because nobody's ever done what we're about to do. Nobody. You know, we were in the Southland years ago. I can't even speak to that. It's a totally different landscape now, different set of rules. So we're trailblazers. I mean, it'll be interesting. So we better put our hats on tight as my guys in the NASCAR would say, reach up and pull those belts tight one more time, right before they say, boogity boogity.
Boogity boogity, that's right, because it's about to go.
Right.
But one last thing here, among the things that will be different, some of the things will still be the same, and that is you're still going to be highly intentional about pumping life into these young men. And you guys have done something just crazy in the college football world. You actually use some of your days in camp to take them to really try to encourage them on a spiritual level. And I know you have plans already again for that in camp.
It doesn't matter what level we would play on. That's what we do. That's who we are. That is a main ingredient for our success.